Hey, what up everybody? This is Hit173 here, bringing you a quick video review of the Toshiba Satellite Radius P55W. It's a Best Buy Blue Tag laptop. It has an Intel Core i7 processor, 5th generation, 8 gig of DDR3 RAM, has an Intel Graphics 5500, and what else? It has a 1080p Full HD IPS display touchscreen. With all the nooks and crannies, like you could turn it on into audience mode, laptop mode, presentation, tablet top, and tablet. Alright, what else am I missing? I'll just show you the full spec list. Okay, that's the full spec list right there. Let's get closer. Like I said, 5th generation Intel Core i7, 5500, 8 gig of DDR3. It's a 15.6-inch TFT LCD high-definition widescreen 10-point multi-touch display, which IPS is, brings out the colors on it. Looks beautiful so far. 1 TB hard drive, 54 RPM, Intel Graphics 5500. Has a high-definition webcam, a multimedia reader. It has 3 USB 3.0 ports. Has the new Intel dual band wireless AC. Bluetooth 4.0. Is brushed aluminum. And brings Windows 8.1 64-bit operating system. Let me show you the keyboard real quick. Has a backlit keyboard just when you're working in the night times. If you need the keyboard light, you can turn it on, off, put it more stronger, whatever you need. There you go, those are the modes that you could put the laptop in. See if I can focus on that. There you go. Laptop, audience, presentation, tabletop, and tablet. I'll show you that in a minute how it works. So far the battery life, I've been getting approximately around, I would say, 8 to 10 hours, depends how what I'm doing with it. If I'm watching a lot of movies, videos, or editing or programming, it takes like around 7 hours to 8, but most of the times I'll be getting 8 to 10 hours. Touchscreen is really fluid. Sometimes I notice that it misses, like when I'm trying to pinch in, it misses like the touch of one of my fingers. I don't know if I don't know how to explain it really good, but for example, I have this stylus, and the stylus for this does not work really good. I don't know why, it just skips a lot. Probably the stylus that I got is really cheap. Most likely, I'm buying a new one. I'm gonna try it out to see if it's the stylus or the touchscreen. Let's see the desktop real quick. It's my desktop, programs that I use. My Street Fighter V poster, wallpaper. See calendar, multitasking, so you could go back to the old screen that you were in. You could remember Windows 8.1, you could put two screens at once and put whichever one you want. Whichever side you want to be bigger, so you can multitask. Okay, let's close that. I got Windows, Microsoft Visual Studios running in the background. Trying to learn some C++. Retail price right now, they have it for $699 on Best Buy on sale. They have it for $150 less. Originally cost like around $850. Sometimes I see it for $900. As you can see, the scrolling is really good. Let's see how the video function works. Let's try it out with Hulu Plus. Rick and Morty. Just a quick video just to show the video quality on a 1080p display.
Presented by Chobani Flip.
Also, may I say, the volume is phenomenal. For a laptop, it's actually louder than my monitor, than my Asus monitor, which is ridiculous.
Savings.
Fucking commercials.
You can't skip this guy.
Okay, commercials are finally done. So you can see the screen looks beautiful. It looks crisp.
Come on, are you kidding me?
Full 1080p.
Almighty! You're not
put the volume down on this. So like I was saying, yeah, the screen looks crisp, full 1080p. Everything looks beautiful. You can put the brightness up if you want, just by the touch keys. Let's see if I can find the shortcut on it. Oh, here we go. There you go, that's the lowest brightness right there. That's the highest it goes. So far, I haven't really tested gaming on it, because I have no games on it. What else? Paint. Okay, now let me show you how it looks in the back. I'll close it down. There you go. This is the sound right there. It's a beautiful looking laptop, I may say. Really beautiful. I like the color of it too, because it doesn't leave fingerprints everywhere. And in the back, it has like a little suede that you could like feel grip on it. So once you have it on the table, on top of a table or something, it does not move that much. Let me try to put it in tablet mode now. Okay, so here is the way you can just turn it into a tablet. All you really gotta do is just push it back, flip it. That's a full stretch right there, all the way up. Then you can put it in intent mode or audience mode, which is like this. So you, if you're watching a video or something, you can just leave it like that. Also, if you're doing some presentation at work, you can always put it like this. You gotta do some presentation in school or class or whatever, you can put it like that. And then of course, full tablet mode, which once you put it in full tablet mode, it blocks the keyboard on the back for the standing. Blocks the keyboard in the back, so basically you just gotta use the screen, touchscreen keyboard. There you go. And sorry about the place. I'm doing this all from the top of my bed right now. So for my password real quick. It's my little doggy over there sleeping. Look at her. She knocked the fuck out. It's Roxy. Roxy! Roxy, look at me. There you go. She's gorgeous. Okay. Well, there you have it, guys. That's a quick review. I'll be back with another video testing the graphic performance. Probably I'll download a game to see how it runs. Probably Battlefield 4 or The Witcher. Something. I don't know. If you guys got any suggestions, something y'all want to see, something y'all want to test, just let me know. Leave me a comment on the section below. And I'll try to answer it as soon as possible. Try to bring you another video of what I could just watch. I want to see or something. If you like the video, if you want to see more, please make sure to subscribe and like the video. And yeah, that's it. Peace, guys. Make sure to like and subscribe.